Come on, open your mouth and give him praise. Come on, open your mouth and give him praise. He deserves the praise. He deserves the honor. He woke you up this morning and clothed you in your right mind. Got the activities of your limbs. Nobody had to help you get dressed today. You're in the right place. Just look at your neighbor and say, you're in the right place today. There's a miracle that's got your name on it. How many of you believe that today? Father, we thank you, Lord, for your loving kindness, your tender mercy, your outstretched hands. We thank you, God, you've been so good to us. You stayed the hand of death and gave us another opportunity to come to these doors of worship and to lift up your name. Father, we thank you that in this morning that we woke up, nothing happened in the middle of the night that would have altered our life for the rest of our life. And we thank you for this day, for this is the day that you have made. This is the day that you've allowed us to come here to get this word that will catapult our ministries in the name of Jesus. Father, we bind the works of the devil and we cast the devil from our minds. Father, I pray that you allow me to speak with clarity, thought, and mind in the name of Jesus. Let your power come and let your Holy Ghost walk up and down the aisles. Rebuke the devil in the name of Jesus. Rebuke the devil in the name of Jesus. Devil, you tried, but God got the victory. And we thank you for the word that is going forth today, God, that would prick the hearts of your people. Let them see where they are and where they're going, that their future is so much better than where they've been. And we thank you. Let the words of my mouth, the meditation of my heart, be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. All the blessed people, if you receive this prayer, open your mouth and give God a praise. Come on, give him a praise. It's not just enough of clapping of your hands. Anybody can clap your hands. But when you have a relationship with God, you will open up your mouth and give him praise every single moment that you have. Come on, I don't hear the praise people in the house. Give God the praise. Give him the praise. Give him the praise. Give him the praise. No matter what it feels like, no matter what it sounds like, no matter what it very well may be, God is the God of your life, and he's able to do anything but fail. We're certainly glad to be here on today. I just need you to look at your neighbor and tell your neighbor, say, neighbor, for the next few moments, you need to give God some praise. You need to put in the atmosphere what you need him to do. And how many of you know that when praises go up, you already know what comes down? Open up your mouth and throw it down your row and say, blessings is coming this way. Throw it down your row and say, blessings is coming this way. You can't hinder my praise because I'm looking for a miracle. I expect the impossible. I feel the intangible. I see the invisible. And the sky is the limit to what I can have. God bless you. Just before you take your seat, let's honor the Lord. Listen, I think I'm in the right place because you said that this is the world's exciting. Well, y'all don't act like you're excited to me. I said this is the world's most exciting church. That's what I want to hear. And to know that you have the most exciting pastor, leader, founder of COF. Come on, the Cathedral of Faith, give it up for our bishop in the house on today. The Bishop Christopher Martin, love you so, so very much. You can be seated in the presence of the Lord. I honor the Lord for this time to come and to be with you. This is actually the first stop that I have since I've been off the tour. Thank you, Jesus. Y'all don't know what I'm talking about. Clark Sisters was on a tour with Kirk Franklin and Ty Trippett, Tamela Mann and David Mann and Israel Houghton, and it was a 30-city tour. And we the Clarkses was the oldest ones on the tour. But God blessed us and allowed us to, that was such a great surprise. Thank you, Lord. Allowing us to go into stadiums again and to be able to minister the songs that y'all know. I'm looking for a miracle. Is my living in vain? is my giving in vain. Come on, Anthony. I'm glad you in the house tonight. Is my praying in vain? Ooh, is my fasting in vain? Came to COF to say, am I wasting my time? Can the clock be rewind? Have I let my light shine? Have I made 99? No. Of course not. Do. It's not all in vain. No. Cause up the road, look at your neighbor and say, just keep living. Tell them, keep coming to church. Cause up the road, up the road, up the road is eternal gain. That was just for COF today. Your living is not in vain. Other songs. You brought the sunshine in my life throughout the lifeline. Save my life. Oh, y'all don't know that song. Since then I have found Christ. There has been such a change in my. Y'all not singing it right. No, y'all not singing it right. Breaks every feeling. Oh, that nothing impossible, nothing invalid, nothing to hold for my God to work. No matter where your problem, God can always solve them. Well, try it today, he will brighten up your day. Pick up your voice, hear you when you're right. Today, I love y'all. I love y'all. I'm so thankful to be here today. So, just coming off of that tour, getting back into Bishop into my ministerial duties, assignments, and responsibilities, which is my first call, and that is to preach the gospel. And so, y'all, my first stop. And I'm excited about it. Thank you so much, Lady Martin. Y'all got to give it up for the wonderful, beautiful, my sister in the spirit, the one and only First Lady Felicia Martin. Love you, dear. Thank you for putting me in the lineup on this weekend with all of these beautiful ladies. It is an honor to be here and to share with you what God is going to give us today. How many of you really know that your future is so much better? That didn't get but three amens. Some of you all that did not say amen, maybe you're just trying to figure out where you're going. But if you have faith, Cathedral of Faith, you already know that God got your life in his hands. And there are some things that he's setting up right now that you will be surprised to see what's going to happen in the next 2 months. Now, I'm speaking prophetically and y'all a little slow now. I'm going to think I'm in Paris and y'all don't understand what I'm saying. I said, you got to understand that if you're a faith believer, always see it, but can't see it, but believe that it's going to happen. That's a faith believer. And if you're a part of this ministry, there's nothing that the enemy can throw in your face and tell you you can't do. All things are possible. All things are possible to them that believe. I don't know about you, but the Bible says it's impossible to please God without faith. So look at your neighbor and say, you better gather your faith journey up. Gather it together and know that you're going somewhere. And the sky is the limit. I scared some of y'all. I said, the sky is the limit. What you can have. Throw it down your row and tell them, say, what's going to happen in the next 7 days is going to blow your mind. Come on, don't be afraid to open your mouth and say it, because you need to open your mouth. It's going to happen in the next 7 days. It's going to blow you. God, I did it again. Got to get happy off my own stuff. What's going to happen in the next 7 days? No matter what the appointment looks like. No matter what the scheduled appointment looks like. God's going to bring a miracle. If you know a miracle's coming, I need you to jump up. No matter how your knees feel, jump up and say, God, I feel a miracle coming to my house, my house, my house. May not be you, but it may be your children. My house. May not be you, but it may be your husband. Not my house. May not be you, but it may be your long-distant relative. My house. Open your mouth and say, it's coming to my house. Tuition's going to be paid. My house. All my bills going to be paid before Christmas. My house. My house. Open your mouth and call your address out. Call it out. Ain't nobody listening at you. Open your mouth. Call your address and say, in the next 7 days, I'm looking for a miracle. I'm going to holler today until God hears me. I said, I'm going to holler today. Am I the only one? I'm going to holler today until God hears me. Hallelujah, hallelujah. On your way down, just tell your neighbor, say, there's a miracle coming in the next 7 days. God said healing is coming in 24 hours. Healing is coming in 24 hours. That means it can start right now. It's according to your prayer. Just thought about what he just told me. According to your prayer is how fast the miracle can come. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Just touch three people and say, I feel a miracle all around me. I feel a miracle all around me, all around me, all around me. Ah, yeah, 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 yeah. Coming, it's coming. Hallelujah. God bless you. Take your seat, take your seat. I don't prepare to be long. Just give me about 15 minutes of your time. And I'm here to tell you. Asha! Hallelujah. I don't know who I'm talking to. But somebody's having problems with their Social Security. I don't know who I'm talking to. But somebody's having problems with just somebody's having problems with your taxes. If you know the God that I know, he makes ways where there is no way. He makes ways when you can't talk to nobody. He makes ways. And if you open your mouth in 24 hours, Some of y'all will see it in the mail. Oscar, you can sit there and act like I ain't talking to y'all. I know who I'm talking. God sent me here to talk to y'all today, to tell you that no problem is too hard for God to work out. No situation is too complicated that God can't work it out. No sickness is too difficult and too hard for God to heal. If I'm talking to you, I tell you to just stand up and say, show your right, show your right, show your right. Quit looking at your cell phone and get in the service. Quit looking at your cell phone and get in your, quit looking at your cell phone and get in the service. God can meet your need. He needs to meet it today, today. You can't even wait till tomorrow. Tomorrow may not even come. You need to open your mouth and give God the praise to him that he's been waiting for the last 2 or 3 hours. Working it out, sister. Working it out, sister DePete. Working it out. Told me to tell, he sent me here to tell you he's working it out. Yes, he is. He's working it out, that grandchild. He's working it out. He's talking to him. Making him behave. He's working it out. I dare you to touch 3 people and say, God is working it out right now, right now. Right now. 12:38, he's working it out. I don't know who I'm talking to online, but God said, don't worry about your bills. They're already being taken care of. If you're in this house, you need to open your mouth if you need God to do it. 24 hours, God's going to turn it around. It's going to work in your favor. Mr. Riley, work in your faith. Work in your faith. Hallelujah. Take a seat. Take a seat. I'm so glad to see. Yeah, there's fire in this room. I tell you, don't look at your cell phone because you're gonna get this. You're gonna become discouraged. Don't look at your cell phone while I'm up because I need to talk to you and tell you some things that God's looking for from us from here on out going into 24. Some people trying to distract you. Some things trying to come in your way to keep you from moving forward in God. And you can't listen to what the enemy is saying. You got to be careful of your cell phone, what you hear and what you see, because your destiny is at stake. Where you're going in your future. God's setting some people up. Matter of fact, he's speaking your name up right now to somebody that you got to go to work for tomorrow. He's speaking your name up. It's clearing the path for you. Right now, he's doing it. Right now, you'll see me and you'll remember me with this blue DCC Rose Collection dress on. That God has you in mind for the next 2 or 3 months. What is that? January, February, March. In those next 3 months, he got you in mind. Open your mouth and say, thank you, sir. Thank you for having me in mind. Let me move quickly. Let me move quickly. Let me move quickly. I honor God for this opportunity to come and to minister to these sisters in the spirit. Brothers, I love you all so much. We appreciate every last brother in this house. All the brothers stand. Ladies, we're going to give them an ovation today. Let's thank God for all these men. These men. And they look like real men. Amen. Some places you go, you can't find real men. You can't find real men. We thank God for all the men that are here that came to celebrate with us in this service. But sisters, it's all about you today. It's about you getting in touch with God. Your connection with God is vitally important. for your future. Amen. Just pass it down your row and say, God's got you in mind. He got you in mind. Got you in mind. Maybe standing in line. Oh, I'm a poet and didn't know it. I say, he got you in line. You may be standing in line, but he's got you in mind. When you go to the mailbox, he got you in mind. Scheduled appointments this week, he got you in mind. That's why we come on Sunday, so we can talk to the Lord and say, God, now they told me this, but here I am right now, and I need you to work this out. That's why Sunday is the first day of the week. We get it all right, get it all clear, so that when we walk into the week, we won't have no hindrances, because you gave God first his time, his first fruits. You gave God his time. So I'm thankful. I'm grateful to be here. I'm so glad to see these mothers that are here. Of course, our church mother, Mother Hayes. She's a dear heart in our jurisdiction. I love her so very much. Come on, congratulate. Mother Hayes is such a sweetheart, and tell you, I don't see no wrong in her. I don't mean that we all not perfect, but she, ever since I've met this woman, she's only been kind to me. And I appreciate her, and we love her in our jurisdiction, and we're going to continue to love her. We love you, Mother Hayes. Certainly to Mother Ellis, and certainly to Mother Griffin. Let's thank God for these wonderful women of the Lord and all these mothers that are here. God bless each of you. You all are the pillar of the church. I know you're the pillar of COF, and we bless God for each of you, and certainly to all of these women, to a governor official. we prophesy. Amen. We prophesy. And we thank God for our wonderful women that are going in this direction. And so we bless God for you. We're praying for you, my sister. Amen. That's why I like to know who's in the house. I have another young lady that has really been following my ministry, and I'm so glad that she's here on today. Sister Alexandria Riley is in the house. We call her Alex. Praise you. Bless you, baby. So good to see you. I also have, and certainly to all of the ministers that are here, pastors that are here, let's thank God. I see Brother Burks, Brother your dad. Doc. Knox, that's right, Knox. I see Elder Knox in the house. God bless you. So good to see you. And certainly to all of the great men that hold up the arms of the bishop, let's thank God for all of them. Thank God for them. And Bishop, before you and First Lady got here, there was a young man that was doing praise and worship. Now I've seen CJ before. I've seen his works before. But I have never seen CJ just stretch out like he did. Yeah. Oh, he stretched it all the way out. And y'all know that CJ is a national, he's a national worker. He works in the national church, working with all of the technology, and he keeps us up on what's going on. And CJ works in our evangelism department. He keeps me looking good on camera. He go in there, Photoshop and everything. But I love it. I was so glad to see him in there and to see him change hats from doing that on all this week up in Las Vegas in our retreat, our winter's retreat. He was there just working that flow. Working that flow, and to see him come back home and do praise him. Y'all ain't hearing me. Y'all don't know what real worship is. Come on, y'all gotta give it up. Come on, this is an encouragement for him. Encouragement for my brother CJ. I love you, man. Auntie, love you. You know that. I love you. And I appreciate what you do for us and the evangelism department. Sometimes we don't get a chance to tell them how we love them and we keep, we have to encourage them. And so this is my time at your home church. Just got back yesterday. Praise the Lord. But we're so glad to see that. My daughter is here, Nikki. Stand up, Nikki. She's been on the road on that 30-city tour with us. And Nikki Cole Beach is, we're trying to make her evangelist. She's in waiting. We're working on her, but God is doing some awesome things. She's been working with her aunties and her mama on that tour and done a fantastic job. I meant to tell you, I wanted to tell you in open, honey, all online, that you did a great job. Making sure your aunties look all good. Everybody kept saying, Lord, what outfits they gonna have on now? It's because of this girl right here. She wanted her aunties and her mama to look good. So we appreciate it. My grandkids are here. Two grandkids. Hello. Hey, DJ. Stand up so they can see who my two grandkids. I only have two grandkids. That's Dion and Kashmir. And so they came with their grandmama. Thank you so much. Thank you. And so we're so grateful. And I've got my MD here. This is my MD. This is my road dog. He'd be on the road with me, Pastor, the one and only Pastor Anthony Taylor. Come on, give it up for him. I love him. Love you, man. And I'm just so thankful because every now and then we got to have somebody that can kind of hold it down. Give it up for these musicians. Musicians, I love y'all. Thank you. Thank you so much. Yeah, they helped out today. And so God got a word for us. I want to hit you and quit you today. I promise I won't be long. But there is a word in this house. I want to go to the book of Hebrews chapter 2. I love you, Lord. I love you, Lord, for your mercies never failing. All my days, come on, help me. I was held in your hand from the moment that I wake up till I lay my head. What I'm gonna do? I will sing of the goodness of God.
I was wondering what's taking you so long.
I love you, Lord. For your mercy never fails me.
All my days.
All my days. I was held in your hand. From the moment that I wake up till I lay my head.
What you gonna do?
I will sing of the goodness. Hebrews chapter 2, verse 1 through 4. Can you stand for the reading of the word? Therefore, we ought to give the most or more earnest heed to the things which ye have heard, lest at any time we should let them slip. If the word spoken by the angels was steadfast and every transgression and disobedience received a just recompense of reward.
How shall we escape if we neglect, if we neglect, if we neglect so great salvation, which at the first began to be spoken by the Lord and was confirmed unto us by them that heard him. God also bearing them witness both with signs and wonders and with divers miracles and gifts of the Holy Ghost according to his own will. He placed emphasis on that first verse. Therefore, we ought to give the most earnest heed to the things which we have heard, lest at any time we should let them slip. Close your Bible, turn your iPad off, your cell phone off, and look at your neighbor and tell your neighbor, say, neighbor, it's a danger in drifting away from God. Just look down your row and tell everybody on your row, say, it's a dangerous thing to slip away or drift away from God. To be seated, that's what I want to talk about. The danger of slowly drifting away from God. Listen at this, and you don't know it. The danger of slowly drifting away from God, and you don't know it. Saints got to know what the warning signs are. Because we can be so caught up into our own stuff. We can be so caught up into church. Until church work, let's say that. And you do know if you are drifting away from God. Recently, sisters and brothers, I've been reflecting on how the Lord has been prompting me to consider the state of our church in the relation and our personal spiritual journey. And everyone under the sound of my voice know that when we are slowing up coming to church, that's a dangerous place to be. We know when other things that we do kind of push God's agenda aside. We know when people, places, and things begin to cause relationship that you made with God, you put it on hold. Everything else has become a priority, but we push God right to the side. Because you haven't taken your attention off of the things that you are doing and putting more attention on God. Well, God now feels some kind of way. Feels some kind of way because now you have allowed other things to come before him. When before your heart was yearning and waiting and wishing, Lord, I need a new refreshing from you. Now we have pushed God to the back burner. I wonder am I talking to anybody in here? Just look at your neighbor, say amen every now and then so you won't look guilty. Just shake your head so I know that you won't look guilty, because I can tell when some of y'all look guilty up in here today. Relationship with God before you go into 2024 has to be intact. Because you've got some goals and you've got some things that you've been talking to God about. You've got some aspirations. You've got some ambitions that you've been talking to God to do. And you got to make sure that your relationship is on talking terms. Here, God feels some kind of way. And let's just put it out there that we've all been at that place where we know we haven't been doing as we should. Testing, 1, 2. Can I get an amen? I've been there. You've been there. All of us have been there where we can sharpen our skills, spiritual skills. And say, God, I could have done better. I could have been more faithful. I could have, you know, at least tried to come to prayer service to even see what it's about. But he filled some kind of way. God feels some kind of way because there, we talked about that today or this week, Bishop, about accountability. That God is holding us accountable for the call that is on your life. He's holding you accountable for the things that you said, yes, God. He's holding you accountable out of everybody in your family. Why are you the only one that's coming to church? He's holding you accountable. Because you have become now the David or the Deborah in the family. Somebody that will seek after God in spite of what I'm dealing with. All I know is God in him himself. That if I neglect so great salvation, I'm doing myself an injustice. The Bible tells us that God is a jealous God. Yeah. And I found out that we can be a part-time lover. Where we can love other things more than God. But God cannot use part-time lovers. He needs all-time workers. The only way that you can continue to stay on your post and stay in your call is that you got to keep doing what you've been doing. What are you saying, Sister Dorinda? If you've been coming to church, keep coming. If you've been watching online, keep watching. But you got, every now and then you got to come to church now. Praise God. Hallelujah. COVID messed us up because it allowed us to become lazy. Allowed us to say, well, I can't get to church. I don't feel like going to church. So I watch on. That's not what church is really all about. Online ministry is for those that can't get to church. Those that are convalescing at home. Those that are in the hospital. Those that cannot get. Thank you, sir. I'm going to have to give you $10 for standing up for that one. Look at your neighbor and say, online ministry. It's for those that can't get to church. He understands and knows where you are. That's the thing. You can fool yourself, but you can't fool God. He woke you up this morning and clothed you. If you're in your right mind, you got the activities of your limb. You better get your up and get to the church house. David said, I was glad. When they said unto me, it's time to go to church. Matter of fact, I got the activities of my limbs. I don't need no help to get dressed. Matter of fact, I put my own hair on today. I didn't need nobody to help me. I got my own self dressed. I got transportation. I got a roof over my head. Thank God your house didn't burn down last night. You woke up this morning, everything was in place. You had food in your cupboard. You got everything around you. Look at your neighbor and say, if you don't know nothing else to thank God for, thank God for life. Thank God for health. It may not be all that you want it to be, but thank God that you got it. God allows you to get to the church house because he knew that some of us would be drifting. Look at your neighbor and say, it's tight, but it's right. Your relationship, take your seat for a moment. Your relationship with God is so vitally important. January 1st of 2024 is getting ready to be one of the greatest years from trauma to triumph. Sister girls, let me tell you, the only way you can see triumph, you can't look at the trauma. Because if you keep looking at the trauma that you've been through, you won't be able to see the trauma. So there's something that's in between trauma and triumph. What is it? It's praise. You can praise God in between. You're on your way to triumph. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, it's not going to be like this always. God's got something better. God's got some things he's about to do. God's got you on schedule. You need to praise God through it so he can bring you completely out of it. Who am I talking to in here? Open your mouth and say, God, help me so that it won't drift. Have you drifted or have you slipped? This is an important question, sisters, because there's a difference between the both. Drifting away from God typically implies that a gradual and unintentional movement away from one spiritual belief. On the other hand, slipping, y'all got me? Slipping away from God suggests a more sudden or accidental separation from one's faith. Now, look at the two of them. One, drifting, it simply means you're gradually unaware of moving away from God. On the other hand, slipping away is a sudden, accidental separation from what you know, from what you believe, that there's a difference between the two. And if you don't find out where you are, you'll find yourself slowly drifting away. I want to find out, what speed are you at? Are you 20 miles an hour, or are you 50 miles an hour? What that? I don't know where you are. You only know where you are at this particular moment. But God brought you here for me to tell you that we got to find out, where are we drifting? How fast are we drifting? What are the warning signs? The warning signs is a lack of spiritual nourishment. Individuals do not actually or get actively involved in spiritual prayer, reading your Bible, and not texting everybody all day long. Gotta find out what's causing you to drift. What is causing you? Are you on your cell phone 24 hours of the day and can't give God any of your prayer time? You have drifted. Look at your neighbor and say, you have drifted. We got to be careful, because sometimes the cell phone is good for all of us, but sometimes the cell phone can become a distraction. Distractions are warning signs. Worldly attractions are warning signs. Worldly influences are warning signs. And we got to be careful so that we won't lose our spiritual place. In today's fast world, people often face numerous distractions that can take priority over your spiritual well-being. And if we're not careful, we'll find ourselves not having a prayer life. We'll find ourselves not coming to praise and worship. We'll find ourselves not coming to Bible class. We'll find ourselves start slowly drifting away from what we know. Constant busyness, materialism, pursuing personal ambitions and leaving God out of your plans. Doubts and questioning. It's natural for individuals to have questions and doubt, but their faith or religion, you got to make sure you know in what you believe. What got you to where you are right now is because of your faith that you had in God. And I stopped by to tell you, you got to watch the warning signs. It's important to note that everyone's spiritual journey is unique. But it's impossible to live your life without God. He has been the priority of our life. And the reason for drifting away from God is because you have lost your connection. I want to share something with you real quick about being in the right place at the right time. Anybody knows that in order to get in the right place to get some reception, talking about this right here, you got to be in a Wi-Fi. Hello. And if you're not in Wi-Fi or 5G, you find out why you can't get some stuff on your phone. Because you've lost connection. And I don't know about y'all. You start losing focus on your relationship with God. And why God ain't answering your prayers is because you're slowly drifting away from Him. And I sometimes can see God saying to y'all, have you talked to me this morning? But yet still you're trying to pray to me and say, God, I want you to let this work. But God's saying, how come you can go on your daily tasks, getting all your money, spending what you want to spend on, but cannot, good God Almighty, take time and talk to the Savior in the morning? Tell your neighbor, say, your priorities have got to be in order going into 2024. A believer should know that you can't live this life without talking to God. Someone said, alone, said, have a little talk with Jesus. Tell him all about your troubles. He'll hear your faintest cry, and he'll answer by and by. Y'all don't know nothing about that song. Said every now and then you feel the little prayer wheels turning. Cause I'm finding out I'm not drifting like the enemy want me to drift. And every now and then you see the little fire burning. What is it that make you keep doing what you're doing? Cause I've had a little talk with Jesus, and he made it all right. Can I get a witness? Open up your mouth and say, Lord, keep me from drifting. I need to know that every time I come in your house, I don't need a praise and worship team to pump me, tell me to lift my hands, tell me to open my mouth. Because when I think of the goodness of Jesus and everything
morning when I realized I had my life. I saw a new dawning. I got out of my bed. My feet touched the ground. I began to walk to the restroom. That let me know that I had God in my view. The Bible says, what you gotta do while you're in this house? David said, I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. Tell your neighbor, say, neighbor, there's no time to drift away. There's no time to stay at home. I gotta get up, no matter who I'm riding with. If I got to leave my ride and catch an Uber, I gotta make sure I talk to Jesus, cause he's got some stuff that he's getting ready to release. Can I get a witness? Shout yeah! If you don't have the passion that you used to have for souls, you're slowly drifting. If you don't come to church like you did have a desire before, you're slowly drifting. If you don't take the time to continue your spiritual man and watch the distractions, you're gonna find yourself slowly slipping and drifting. Tell your neighbor, say, from this day forward, tell them we gotta make up in our mind who we gonna serve. Is it gonna be God or material things? Is it gonna be God or your flesh? Is it gonna be God? I made up in my mind, a charge to keep, a God to glorify, that I'll let nothing separate me from the love of God. Tell your neighbor, say, neighbor, we can't drift, cause we got too much money we're getting ready to make. We got too many dollars we're getting ready to go. God is telling us, get up, rise up, get ready, for eyes have not seen, neither ears have not heard the great things. Tell your neighbor, say, great things that God has for you in the store. I said in the store, sister girls, in the store and in store. Yes, for you, with your name on it, nobody can get it but you. When you pick up your mail from the mailbox, what name are you looking for? Open up your mouth and talk to me. What name are you looking for? You need to put your hand on your chest and say, my name. Because guess what? Your name has got investment. Your name has got deliverance. Your name is getting ready to put you in places that you never saw. Your name is getting ready to be great. Not just on a card, but it's getting ready to be on the billboard. Just like me in Times Square. Just the other month, they told me that my name, my beauty line, was in Times Square on the billboard. I'm thinking that the billboard was just like that. They said, it's not like that. I said, well, how does it look? They said, come on here. I'm gonna take you to Times Square and let you see how God has made your name great. Yes, he did. They took me to Times Square. I said, well, where is it? They said, we gotta wait about 5 seconds for it to show up on the bill, on the billboard. I stood there and I waited. I didn't drift, but I waited until I saw my name, my picture on a billboard that was big as that whole wall. Y'all ain't hearing me. He said, I'll make your name great and put you before kings and queens. Can I get a witness? Tell somebody, get them by the hand and say, God, y'all ain't looking at me. I said, get somebody by the hand and tell them, God is not finished with you. Your destiny got money tied to it. Your destiny got your children tied to it. Your destiny got your grandchildren tied to it. The Bible said, lift me up, lift me up, and I'll draw all men unto you. I'll draw the white man. I'll draw the black man. I'll draw all nationalities. If you lift me up, because the sky is the limit to what I can have. If I go after it, if I got faith, I know he's able to do exceedingly, abundantly, above all you can ask or think. So don't worry if they don't call your name. God is stirring some things up, getting you ready, that what they meant for evil, God's getting ready to turn it around for your good. Who am I talking to? I dare you to look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, the next time I turn around, God's getting ready to put it in my hand. Y'all get ready to turn around and say, Lord, you told me if I ask, it shall be given. If I see it, I will find it. If I knock, the door shall be open. Open your mouth, touch 3 people, and say, God's getting ready to make your name great. Get ready. God's getting ready to show you the right people. Show you the right property. Show you the right thing to go after. If I'm talking to you, I dare you to scream so God can hear. Scream for him to make your name. Scream for him to give you health. Scream so he can do it now. Shout yeah! Shout yeah! Shout yeah! Who am I talking to? I dare you to get out of here. Get in this spot. If you need God to work it out, if you need God to give you favor, if you need God to hold back the enemy, if you need God to touch your family, if you need God to heal your body, it's for those that want it, are the ones that go receive it. I need you to lift your hand and say, Lord, help me not to drift from your anointing, not to drift from your prayer life, not to drift from being faithful. I need more. I need more. I can't. without you. I need you to walk with me, talk with me, make me have the right decision. Show me who to talk to. Give me the right door to go in. In the name of Jesus, we decree it, we declare it, it is so. I need you to open your mouth so God can do it. If you need him to work it, open your mouth. If you need him to change it, open your mouth. If you need him to direct you, open your mouth and say, Lord, you know where I am. But whatever you do, don't take your spirit from me. I need it for direction. I need it for guidance. But yea, though I walk through the valley and the shadow of death, I won't be fearing evil, because you are with me, a lamp unto my feet, a light unto my pathway, that when I call on you, you'll come running. Open up your mouth and give God a praise that won't wait. Come on, give him a praise. Come on, give him a praise. Somebody said, I'm only gonna say so much. But when you know him for yourself, you got a good relationship, you'll talk to him anytime. Open your mouth and say, Lord, here I am. Help me not to drift from you. Come on and clap your hands and give God. Come on, this is a good time to pray. joy I have. The world didn't give it, and the world can't take it away. If you doubt it,
if these people are excited about their future. Because today is the day that you'll have no excuse of drifting. I want everybody to sit down. Everybody sit down. I'm gonna do a flash mob. I want you to think about two things that God did for you. I don't need you to jump up yet. I don't need you, I just want you to start thinking of what man could not do, but God did. You know, when you went to the doctor and the doctor said to you, you got cancer, your first thing was zoomed in on God. I know he's able to heal my body. Even if it's not that, something that you knew God did. Now look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, you have no excuse. When Sister Dorinda tell you, this is your time to shout. Everybody got something to thank. I don't care how cute you are. I don't care how you say, I can't dance. You better pick them up and put them down or I'm coming after you. Look at your neighbor and say, get ready, get ready. Because not only am I looking at you, but God sees you. And the ways that he's made and the ways that he's getting ready to make, you got to put an advance praise on what God is about to do. Look at your neighbor and say, are you really ready? Get your feet ready. Get your feet ready. I don't care if your feet hurt, take your shoes off. If your knees hurt, you're going to get healed. When I count to three, I want everybody to get up, and I need you to, if you don't know how to shout, I need you to act like you know how to shout. And everybody got to have your head down. That means that you really got to praise and you got to get it out. Look at your neighbor and say, get ready, get ready. And this is the last praise for the day. And you got to think about two or three things that God did. One, two, three. Come out. Get your head down. And start. Ah, shy. Come on now. Thank you, sir. You didn't have to do it, but you did. You saved my family. You saved my children. You're working some things out. You're giving me favor. You're talking to some people that by the time Wednesday comes, everything it's gonna be all right. Shatanamokoraba. Come on, praise him. Thank you, sir. That's what I'm talking about. And he's looking at your praise. Said he's looking at your praise. Said he's looking at your praise. Daddy, looking at your praise. And your praise about to bring it. Your praise about to bring it. About to give you relief. About to save your family. Change your perspective. Give you favor. Woo! Thank you, Lord. Say, by this time,
to slipping, drifting away from God. And I will no longer allow things, people, places, situations to cause me to drift from God. I don't know who I'm talking to in here, but there might be somebody that don't know Jesus. If you don't know Jesus, this is a great time to get to know him. Everybody's standing. Not have a service of this magnitude and not offer Christ to those of you that don't know Jesus. Why would you live life without him? After all, he bore your sins. After all, he gave you life. And not just have life, but you have it more abundantly, which means you express that since I know Jesus, I have everything that I need. But I can't talk to mama when I can't talk to daddy. When I can't talk to my best friend, Jesus is the best friend. And what I love about Jesus, ladies, is that he's your man and my man at the same time. He's the only man that can have all of us women at one time. We can certainly say, I don't mind him going to your house. And you don't mind him coming to my house. Because he's omnipresent. He's everywhere at the same time. And he can work your situation out and mine out at the same time. Who wouldn't want a man like this that can make sure that you're taken care of? Treat you like a queen, even though you're single. All the single ladies, all the single ladies, all the single ladies, all the single ladies, make sure they put a ring on it. Don't flirt around with them. Don't let them string you along. Why would you have somebody that will take care of you? Look at your neighbor and say, I'm so glad I got Jesus. He's the best man and the best friend that you could have. You can tell him something, and I ain't got to worry about him spreading it. Jesus knows how to hold our secrets. We don't have to worry about him. If you don't know Jesus, you would just slip that hand up and say, I'd like to get to know that man you're talking about, Jesus. And the thing about it is that now you go in churches, everybody has a relationship with him. There are times when we drift away. And we all been attested to that fact that we have drifted. But just look at somebody and say, I'm back on track. On track because I know Jesus. If you're here today and you don't know Jesus, this is your time. You can step out right quick. If you don't know him, let's have that good relationship with him. I promise you, God can change your life and you'll never be the same again. I got to know Jesus at 19 for real. Y'all know when it was the times when we come to church and we tarry and we get to know Jesus, we could go back out there and do something wrong.